South Iceland boasts a rich variety of natural beauty and social activity, extending all the way from the shoreline to the mountains inland. Here, a whole range of spectacular natural forces vie for the traveler's attention. Today, South Iceland is the most popular destination choice amongst visitors all the year round. The country's most hallowed historical site is Þingvellir National Park, where Iceland's first National Assembly was established by early settlers over 1,000 years ago. Þingvellir is also where, in the most dramatic way, one can see how the continents of America and Eurasia are pulling apart from each other atop the North Atlantic Ridge. The Geysir high temperature area, with its world-famous erupting hot springs, is a must for any visitor, as indeed is the magnificent nearby Gullfoss waterfall. Travelling eastwards along the south coast, one sees just why Iceland is called the land of ice and fire. Tourist amenities in the south include a wide variety of recreational activities available all the year round and catering to every age and interest. The Vatnajökull National Park is the largest national park in Europe and offers endless opportunities for exploring nature. East of the park is the picturesque fishing village of Höfn, famous for its lobster fishing. The various museums, saga centers, art galleries, and handicraft centers reflect the rich heritage of the region's past and present. In the south, you'll find every type of accommodation imaginable. And when it comes to dining out, there's a whole range of restaurants to choose from. The town of Selfoss is the largest town in the south and offers all the services a tourist might need. A number of other small towns are scattered further along the south coast, each worth a visit. For a true taste of Iceland, the south is the perfect destination at any time of the year. Its diversity of nature, its fascinating cultural heritage, and the endless choice of recreational activities will give you memories to cherish a lifetime. And best of all, you're always assured the warmest of Icelandic welcomes.
This is a project from the 7th class in the elementary school in Hveragerði.
Eldsneyti er dýrt og það mengar mikið. Fuel is very expensive and it causes a lot of pollution. Ætli einhver á Íslandi hafa hugsað sér að nota rafbíla eða metan? Do you think someone in Iceland has thought of using methane over electric cars?
Methane is lyktarlaus og litlaus gas sem er léttara en andrúmsloftið.
Methane is odorless and colorless gas that is lighter than air.
Það myndast við rotnun lífræns úrgangs og loftfiðrar aðstæður.
It is formed during the decompositions of organic waste under anaerobic conditions.
Finns í eða nálægt mýrum, leitlandi, gamlum urðunarsvæðum og gamlu skólandi.
And is found in or near wetlands, old landfill areas and old forest.
Methane sem lífeldsneyti er til dæmis notað á bíl.
Methane as biofuels for example is used for car.
Læsilegt.
Pappi hans vinnur í fyrirtæki sem heitir Dyker. He sells... My father works at a company called Dyker. Hann selur hnífa, vasaljós og hreinsivörur. He sells knives, flashlights and cleaning products. Hann keyrir og selur þessa hluti en hann notar ekki bensín, hann notar steikingarolíu.
He drives around and sells his products but he doesn't use fuel. Use frying oil.
Mér finnst að allir ættu að nota steikingarolíu. Hún er neitsamleg.
I think everyone should use frying oil. It's really, really useful.
metanstöðar á Íslandi?
Metangas are not expensive and there are about 3 metan stations in Iceland.
Rafbílar eru líka ódýrir og menga lítið.
Electricas are also not expensive and do not cause a lot of pollution.
Ef allir ættu metan eða rafbíla væri mjög lítið mengun á Íslandi.
If everyone had metan or electric cars, then there would be like no pollution in Iceland.
Tré eru mikilvægustu plöntur í heiminum.
Trees are the most important plants in the world.
Þau búa til súrefni handa okkur.
They make us oxygen.
En nú hefur skógarhögg aukist.
But more and more trees have been cut down.
Og ef öll trén verða að fara niður.
But if all the trees will be cut down,
þá eru ekkert súrefni eftir á jörðinni.
Then no oxygen will be left.